Hi everyone, so in this video I'm going to show you how to crochet this little winter pixie hat, which can be made in any size. So for my pixie hat I used a 4mm crochet hook, and in this video I am using US terms. So thank you very much for watching, and please make sure to subscribe to my channel for more crochet videos. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to make a slip knot. So to do a slip knot, you want to take your yarn and you want to take your finger and you want to wrap the yarn around your finger once and then twice. Then take the first loop and pull it over the second loop, and then take the second loop and pull it all the way over your finger. You then want to take your crochet hook and go in through this space and pull tight. And there you have a slip knot. So once you have your slip knot, you now want to make your foundation chain. And your foundation chain must be a multiple of 6. So you can make your foundation chain as long or as short as you like, as long as it is a multiple of 6. And your foundation chain must be long enough to fit around the head of the person who your hat is going to be for. So you want to take your foundation chain and place it under the chin and then go all the way around the head, and it must be able to come round at back and touch where it started. So your foundation chain must be long enough to fit around the head of the person who your hat is going to be for, and it must be a multiple of 6. And I am making my hat for a 9 to 12 month old, so an age 9 to 12 months, and I'm going to chain 54. So I'm going to chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way up to 54. So once you have worked your foundation chain, we are now on to round 1 of our hat. And for round 1, we're going to start off by chaining 2. You want to make 2 extra chains onto the end of your foundation chain to begin round 1. And no matter how long or short your foundation chain is, you need to do 2 extra chains. And now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to make a single crochet into the second chain from the hook. So here is the first chain from the hook, and here is the second, and into this stitch we're going to do a single crochet. So to do a single crochet, you want to insert your hook into the chain, so the second chain from the hook, then yarn over and pull up a loop, and then yarn over and pull through both loops on your hook. And that is one single crochet. And we are now going to skip the next 2 chains. So we're going to skip this chain and this chain. And into this chain, we are going to make our first shell. And for our shell, we are going to do double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1, double crochet all into this stitch. And that makes a shell. So we have worked a single crochet into the second chain from the hook. We're now going to skip the next 2 stitches, and into the next stitch we're going to make a shell. So we're going to start off with a double crochet, and to do a double crochet you yarn over and go into the chain, making sure that you are skipping those first 2 chains, and then yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through 2 loops, and yarn over and pull through the final 2 loops. So that is 1 double crochet, and you then want to chain 1 and go back into the same stitch and work a second double crochet, chain 1 again, and then back into the same stitch or the same chain and work a third double crochet like that. And there you have your first shell. So we are now going to skip the next 2 chains again, or the next 2 stitches, and into the next chain we're going to work another single crochet. So skip 2 chains and into the next one and work a single crochet. So insert your hook into the chain, yarn over and pull up a loop, and yarn over and pull through 2 loops. So what we have just worked there, we are going to repeat again and again for row 1. We are going to skip 2 chains and then work a shell into the next chain. And a shell is double crochet, chain 1, double crochet, chain 1, double crochet all into the same chain. And we're then going to skip two more chains and then work a single crochet into the next chain. And just repeat that again and again for round one. So we're going to begin our next repetition. So we're going to skip two chains and into the next chain work a shell. So I'm going to yarn over and skip the two chains and go into the next chain or the next stitch and work a double crochet. So yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two loops, and yarn over and pull through two more loops. Then chain one and work another double crochet into the same chain. Chain one again and work a final double crochet into that same chain. Just like that. So there we have our next shell, and we're now going to skip the next two chains and into the next one work our next single crochet. So insert your hook into that chain, yarn over and pull up a loop, and then yarn over and pull through both loops on your hook. So there we have our next repetition, and you just want to keep repeating that. So we're going to skip two stitches and do a shell, and then skip two more stitches and do a single crochet. Skip two stitches, shell, skip two stitches, single crochet, and just keep repeating that for round one. So I have just worked that all the way along for round one, and I am coming to the very end. And to finish off round one, you just want to work the same thing as you have done all the way along. You should have worked your last shell, and then you want to skip the next two stitches, and you should have one chain left, and into that last chain you're going to work your final single crochet. So if you look at the end here, this is my slip knot and this is my last chain. So there's the slip knot and there's the chain. And into this last chain, I'm going to work a single crochet. So just like that. And once you have done that, we are now ready to move on to round two of our hat. So we are now on to round two of our hat, and we are going to begin round two by chaining four and turning. So you want to chain one, two, three, four, and then turn. And this chain four counts as our first double crochet and chain one. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to work a double crochet into this very first stitch here. So this is the first stitch that our chain four comes out of. So you want to yarn over and go into this stitch, and the stitch that we are going into is the last single crochet from the previous row. So then we are going to yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through two loops, and yarn over and pull through the final two loops. So that is a double crochet into the first stitch, and we are now going to go into our shell. So here is our first shell. So there's double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet, and we're going to go into the center of this shell. So into the very middle double crochet, and into this double crochet, we are going to work a single crochet. So that will mean that we are doing a single crochet into the top of the shell. So you want to go into the center double crochet, or the second double crochet, and work a single crochet. Like that. And we are now going to go into the next single crochet from the previous round. So skip the last bit of this shell and go to the single crochet. And the single crochet is in between the two shells. So it's this little stitch here. And into this single crochet, we are going to do a shell. And we're going to work a shell in the exact same way as we did in round one, or in the previous round. We are going to do double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet to make a shell, and we're going to do that into the single crochet here. So yarn over and go into the stitch and work a double crochet, then chain one and work another double crochet, and this is all into the single crochet, chain one, and then work a final double crochet. Like that. So there we have done a shell into the single crochet. And you want to repeat that all the way along. We're going to do a single crochet into the top of, or into the center of, every single shell. and then we're going to work a shell into the single crochet. So we will have shell, single crochet, shell, single crochet, shell, single crochet, all the way along for round two. So we are going to work our single crochet into this next shell. So go into the second double crochet, so skip the first part of the shell and go into the very middle and work a single crochet. And then into the next single crochet along, we are going to do a shell. So our single crochet is in between the two shells. It's this small stitch here, and we're going to do double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet into this stitch. So there is our next repetition, and we're going to do that again. Single crochet into the top of the next shell, and then shell into the next single crochet. And just keep repeating that all the way along for round two. So I'm just coming to the end of round two, and I'm going to work a single crochet into my last shell, so into the center of my last shell, just as I've been doing all the way along. And then to finish off the round, I'm going to do double crochet, chain one, double crochet into this last single crochet. So it's technically half a shell. And if you remember at the beginning, we chained four and then we did a double crochet into the first stitch, and that counted as double crochet, chain one, double crochet. So half a shell at the beginning. So we need to do that at the end. So we are going to go into the single crochet. So this is the very first single crochet that we worked. And into this stitch, we're going to do double crochet, chain one, double crochet. So here is the single crochet. And if you look, you can kind of count back from your stitches. This is the chain one. This is the double crochet. So this stitch here must be the single crochet. So into this stitch, I'm going to do my first double crochet. Then I'm going to chain one and then do a final double crochet. So it's like half a shell, and that just gives us nice neat edges for our hat. And once you have done that, we are ready to begin round three. So we are now on to round three of our hat, and we are going to start round three by chaining one and turning. And this chain one does not count as a stitch. This just allows us to turn our work. And now into the very first stitch. So this is the last double crochet from the previous row. We are going to do a single crochet. So here's the chain one and here is the double crochet. And into this stitch, we're going to do a single crochet. So insert your hook into the stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, and yarn over and pull through two loops. And there we have a single crochet. And for this row, we are going to do the exact same thing as we did last row. It just starts differently and ends differently. We are going to do a shell into every single crochet, and then we are going to do a single crochet into the top of every shell. So row three is going to be single crochet, shell, single crochet, shell, single crochet, shell, all the way along in the same way as round two. So it's the exact same thing, it just starts differently and ends differently. So we've done a single crochet, so now into the next single crochet here, we are going to do double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, double crochet one, or a shell. So we're doing a shell into the next single crochet. Just like that, and then into the next shell, into the center of the shell, so the second double crochet, you want to do a single crochet, and then into the next single crochet, work another shell, and just repeat this all the way along for row three. So I am just coming to the end of row three, and I have worked my final shell. And now to finish off round three, we are going to end with a single crochet. So just the same as any repetition, we're going to end with a single crochet, but we don't have a shell here to work into. We have half a shell. We have the chain four and then double crochet that we worked. So we are going to work our single crochet into the third chain of the chain four. And the chain four counted as a double crochet and a chain one. So by working into the third chain, you are technically working into the first double crochet. So here is the double crochet and here is the chain four. So this is the fourth chain and this stitch here is the third chain. And into this chain, so the third chain, I'm going to work my final single crochet. So insert your hook into the chain, yarn over and pull up a loop, and yarn over and pull through two loops. And once you have done that, this is what you have. So you kind of get shells slotted in between shells, and having the chains gives a really nice effect. And we are ready to move on to the next round.
So I have just completed rows 1, 2 and 3 and I'm on to the next row of my hat. And for the rest of our hat, we are simply going to repeat row 2 and then row 3 again and again for the rest of our hat. So we've just finished row 3 or round 3. So you now want to repeat round 2 again. And then you want to repeat round 3, then round 2, then round 3, then round 2, then round 3. And we will end up with a long piece, so a rectangle, and we're going to fold this and sew this up the back. And I will show you how to do that once I have worked the body of my hat. And the number of times that you repeat those two rows depends on the size hat that you are doing. So I am making my hat age 9 to 12 months, and I'm thinking that I will probably want 20 rows in total. But I will let you know how many rows that I did in the end once I have worked them and I can see the size. But just work until you feel that your hat is big enough. So simply repeat round 2 and then round 3 again and again until you feel that your hat is big enough. And I will have the written pattern for those two rounds on the screen in a second, or you can go back and re-watch the video. But rounds 2 and round 3 are practically the same thing, but you start round 2 with a chain 4 and turn, and then doing a double crochet into the first stitch. Then work single crochet shell all the way along and end with double crochet, chain one, double crochet into the last single crochet. And then for round 3, you chain one and turn and then work a single crochet into the first stitch. Then do shell, single crochet all the way along and end with a single crochet into the third chain of the chain four. But like I said, I will have the written pattern on the screen in a second, or you can go back and watch the video. So just keep repeating those two rounds. Okay, so I have just finished working the body of my hat and I worked 16 rows in total, and that included the first three rows that I showed on camera and then the repeats of row 2 and row 3. And I now feel that my hat is big enough, and we are going to fold our hat and sew it at the back. So if you want to see how many rows to work, you can fold your hat and then get another hat in the same size and see if that is the right size or if you need to work more rows. But I am finished for now. So what I'm going to do is I am now going to sew up one of the sides of my hat. So we have a rectangle here and you want to fold your rectangle, and we are going to sew up along the chain that we worked at the very beginning. So here is where I have just finished off, and this is the chain or the foundation chain that we worked at the beginning of our hat. And we are going to sew this up along the fold. And I have this piece of yarn here, and this is the tail that I left when I made my slip knot. So when I made my slip knot at the very beginning of my hat, I left a nice long tail so that I could use this tail to sew up my hat at the end. So what we are going to do is we are going to thread our yarn onto a yarn needle, and I have one of these ones with the squidgy ends at the top, and we are just going to fold our hat in half, and we are going to sew up this edge. So like I said, this is the edge with the foundation chain. So I have my yarn, and I'm going to go into the same stitch on the opposite side and pull my yarn and needle through. And then I'm going to go into the next stitch, and I'm going to go back into the same one on the opposite side and pull my yarn through. And I'm just going to keep doing this all the way up my hat. Just sew it up along the back. Okay, so I have just sewn my hat all the way up the back, and then I turned my hat inside out. There is no right or wrong side to this hat, as we turned our work with every row, but once you sew it up the back, turning it into the opposite way makes the seam less noticeable. And here I have finished my little pixie hat. And the final thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to make a chain on either side. So here I have my work where I finished off, and I have just put a stitch marker in this last stitch here to keep it secure. So I'm going to remove my stitch marker, and you want to make sure that you do equal chains on either side. So I think I'm going to probably chain around about 40, but I will see how I go. So I'm going to start chaining, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach another piece of yarn in the same colour onto this side of my hat and make the same length. Okay, chain. So I have made two ties on the end of my hat, and I have weaved all of my ends into the inside of my hat, and I have finished. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and found it easy to follow. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel for more crochet videos, and thanks again for watching. Bye!